The following podcast has been brought to you by Audible.com. Sign up now using the URL audibletrial.com/TTV to get a free audiobook of your choosing. We recommend Brick by Brick, How LEGO Rewrote the Rules of Innovation and Conquered the Global Toy Industry. You may recognize this as one of the sources we use in our show, Bionicle Autopsy. Remember, that's audibletrial.com/TTV. Enjoy the show.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1,
sync.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to episode 159 of the TTV Podcast.
Mardi Gras.
Mardi Gras.
Mother.
What was that?
That was really creepy.
That sounded like one of those neo-modern advertising things, you know? It's like people walking in the desert in slow motion.
Mardi Gras.
Are we going to start? Is that our next plug? Special TTV shampoo?
Yeah.
Yes, the shampoo.
No, our next plug is, if you're watching this on YouTube, you're going to be late.
Oh, yeah. Let's go ahead and talk about vessels since the past couple weeks.
I meant to write down the advertisement this time because I'm tired of stumbling over my words.
Do you want me to do it?
I don't want you to do it.
Okay, fine.
No, it's okay. I hate you. We can just skip past
this. I think we can just... Anyway. So if you're watching this on YouTube, you are a week behind. Definitely check us out on vessel.com/the TTV channel, and you can access all of our podcast episodes when they're released on time for free. And there's also a little side option where you can pay for early access to get all of our videos early if you want.
$3
a month. If you want. You don't have to, but...
$3 a month.
If you want.
And it's also appreciated very much.
It's very much appreciated.
Yes.
It helps us out a lot.
It helps the show out quite a lot, and just simply watching us on Vessel, even if you don't go with the early access option, really, really, really helps us. So, just being a viewer and being a cool person, you're helping us out. And if you want us to keep making shows like this one and keep powering through, then it's a no-brainer, right?
We're gonna start
like editing all those after shows and getting all those done.
More vessel exclusive content.
More vessel exclusive content.
Kind of so reward really those people.
Right. Yeah. If you guys subscribe to us, I know it's kind of sparse at the moment, but you will be getting some exclusive stuff very, very soon.
Yeah, and eventually we'll get to that stage where if you do subscribe, which means something different on Vessel, we'll give you a complimentary bottle of Sham Marty.
What?
Sham Marty.
Is it spelled as in
Marty?
Sham Marty.
Yeah, okay, yeah.
Episode 159. Sham Marty.
I don't even want to do that. That would be disingenuous. That would be pretending that was a good joke, but it wasn't.
I guess you could say it'd be a sham.
No one's laughing, Jay.
Literally misinformation.
You're gonna die alone now, Jay.
I don't understand why you're laughing so hard at that.
I know.
Oh,
it's
funny. No, Kahi, he won't die alone. I'll be there.
You will?
Oh, no. Nice. Murder.
You will?
Brutal murder.
It's like Eljay dying on his deathbed and Takuma sat there. He's just like, oh, you came to say bye. He's just like, no,
here
I came to watch
joke
you die.
Nice. Takuma, I hate you. Shut up.
I don't hate Takuma.
It's just
a funny
Takuma
guy.
watching him slowly die. He doesn't even say anything. He just...
Also, shirts at store.tdbpodcast.com and Audible Trial.
We'll do that at the end. We'll do the shirts.
We'll do the other plugs at the end. We don't need to do all those.
This is just the first, the reminder, man.
Yeah,
complimentary.
Vessel's the important
plug.
One. Man, Vessel rocks. I love
Vessel's
Vessel.
Amazing,
Vessel is
man.
A wonderful, wonderful service.
Vessel
it's,
is
It's
best.
So nice being, like, actually, well, you know, having people actually interested in how our channel does.
Uploading a streamline that people in charge of managing the site are very nice and helpful. Everything is good.
It's just nice to talk to an actual person instead of an automated machine.
Yeah,
like you would know.
Or talking to anything at all, because YouTube, has nothing. There is no communication at all.
Nope.
Absolutely nothing. Let's jump ship to YouTube Gaming and start live streaming our stuff, guys.
I did not know that YouTube Gaming was like a failed concept. I thought people really loved that, but you informed me last night that people were hating it.
I would imagine.
Wait, really?
I
haven't paid any attention to it.
I didn't even know it existed.
Let's introduce ourselves and then I'll fill you in.
Okay, yeah.
I'm messing up.
I'm Bartaran.
I'm LJ.
I'm Kahi.
I'm Viper.
I'm Takuma Nuva.
And this is TTV 159. Anyway, yeah, basically, I don't doubt that some people like YouTube Gaming because people are using it. However, all of the big news stories I've seen about it have been negative things. I know that there was a bunch of copyright issues because basically, unlike
I did hear about that.
Unlike Twitch, YouTube Gaming has the same copyright policies that YouTube has, except this time, while you're streaming, they can shut down your stream midway through if they detect copyright.
Yeah, you know, and I did hear that like part of that was like they detected that the in-game audio was copyrighted, which it is, but they were streaming the game, so they had to have the audio, and they would shut down several streams in like their audio because they thought they were playing copyrighted content.
You know,
like Metal Gear Solid that came out, it has like a lot of popular music, you know, and you find cassette tapes around the world.
Yeah.
That got them in trouble.
Another thing I've heard for people that do YouTube as their full-time job or even a part-time job and they make money off of it, I'm not saying this with absolute certainty. This could be misinformation. It could be just a bug one person got. But from what I have heard, you can't even monetize your streams on YouTube Gaming. They launched without that feature.
Wait, what? Why?
It's still in beta and they're still testing.
Why did they launch it then?
I don't know. But again, like, take that with a grain of salt. But
no, I mean, I get why they launched it. They did the beta so they could test server load. You know, if everybody's streaming at the same time, how's this going to reflect on
how the server works? Is it considered a full launch or is it considered a beta launch?
Yeah, because I thought this was a full launch. I didn't hear this was beta at all.
I don't really know.
But I mean, that would make sense.
If they had advertised it as
well,
a beta,
let's also be fair. Twitch doesn't really have monetizing either. A lot of the people that make money off Twitch do it via donations.
Yes.
Yeah, like subscriptions and donations.
Right.
Which is an interesting business model.
So, I don't know.
I mean, which is true, but, like, I don't know. It seems like monetization is a no-brainer. That's, like, the one thing that YouTube so far has had over all the competitors.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But maybe they'll get there.
I mean, yeah.
Because if you do Twitch, you've got to have, like, mods in the chat, otherwise you get a bunch of spam bots and things like that.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Well, I mean,
I've heard that YouTube Gaming isn't much better in that aspect.
Yeah, I haven't seen YouTube Gaming personally, so I wouldn't know, but I've been to many Twitch streams and I've seen a couple spam bots everywhere.
The real deal, I feel, is that like YouTube, they're not offering a better service than Twitch. They're offering the same service under the YouTube banner. And that's what's getting people kind of like, oh, it's just literally another Twitch. You just decided to roll this out so that you can compete.
Well, I think a lot of people would argue that simply being under the YouTube banner does make it better because then you've got all these places in one area.
Right.
So like, we're already kind of experiencing that a little bit with Vessel, where we've moved over to Vessel and like some people are kind of wary about going to Vessel because, you know, all their other subscribers are already on YouTube, so there's no point in leaving.
Yeah.
And I get that. It's an audience thing. It's convenient for other people to be on one thing.
It's kind of a gamble.
So, like, if you can watch all your streams and watch all your favorite subscribers on the same place, why not? It makes sense.
Yeah.
YouTube's kind of got that thing where, like, they're so dominant right now that they don't really necessarily have to offer a better service to be successful.
Right.
Yeah.
Not completely.
They're like Nintendo in the early, like, 80s, back when the NES was the only good system.
I wouldn't call it a monopoly, but it's close.
Yeah.
It's close.
Yeah, Google has a monopoly over most of the internet, I feel. Like,
I'm telling you guys.
I see Google everywhere.
Here we go.
I mean, YouTube is Google.
Eljay coming in.
But I'm not, like, paranoid about it, though, like you are, Eljay. I mean, I'm concerned about the business.
I've seen the future, okay? War will break out!
You've seen the future? I think you need to go see a doctor, Eljay.
It's only a matter of time before Google changes their logo again, and now it reflects Skynet.
Yeah, it reflects...
What's up with that?
Reflect 666. If you look carefully, you see Illuminati.
Like there's a program like that does the. I think their giant like weather balloon internet service that they're trying to do that, like, you know, to provide internet everywhere is actually codenamed Skynet or something in Google's codenamed Skynet.
I would love to do that just to scare people.
Well, think about it. Why would it be called Skynet? Because who works on these projects? Nerds. And what will nerds do? Name stuff after nerdy stuff because they think that's cool. So,
oh, yeah.
It would be like a self-fulfilling prophecy. Skynet won't be made because, like, oh, it's a company. It'll be like, oh, remember Terminator? Dude, this is so cool. We're making Skynet.
Hey,
it is a thing. It is already a thing in other examples. I can't think of anything specific
right now.
It's
not like
it's
not an evil thing. It's because nerds are nerds.
Nah, man.
They're building the internet.
It is evil. Pure evil. Evil makes itself known to the world.
I guess YouTube gaming does have some...
You want a prime example? Just go to ThinkGeek.
I guess YouTube gaming does have some fans because Jimmy Kimmel talked about it. And he bashed it, apparently.
He bashed
nothing to do with YouTube gaming.
Yeah. He bashed, like, people watching games as a whole.
Oh. He watched that Let's Plays. Or he bashed Let's Plays.
And see, I think that's a very... That's a really terrible PR move on his part. Because... It's a familiar concept of people his age and like an older generation of people that are still watching late night TV, but he distanced himself that night. TV's dead. TV is dead and is dying a slow death and will soon.
It is.
Like,
it really is.
But there's a divide now, and he's really put himself like, oh, I'm out of touch of his generation. I literally have no idea what's going on now.
Yeah, it's also kind of interesting because a lot of other TV show hosts of that nature, they're getting super into gaming. Conan, Jimmy Fallon.
Conan is probably the one I've seen the most get into.
Yeah,
he's got his own YouTube series.
He plays games before they're out. Like last 2 years, I saw him playing Halo 4 right before launch.
Yeah, he played Halo 5.
Did he voice someone in Halo 4?
There you go.
He is in Halo 4.
He's the box dude. I don't know who the other guy is, but they were both.
It's Conan and his sidekick dude. I forgot what they called him.
Oh yeah, it is.
You know what?
If
Conan was smart, what he would do is that he would start doing live streams, like Twitch streams of Let's Plays of games with popular celebrities. Like he would have a celebrity join him for an hour, and they would do a Let's Play.
Does he do that? I'm not sure.
I'm going to look that up then, because I would like to see that. Like, you know, even better than just someone sitting in, I'd like to see, like, a casual gameplay of, like, you know, freaking Conan and, like, Taylor Swift or something. I don't know.
Yeah.
Taylor Swift.
That would be awesome. I would
watch
that.
Yeah.
I like how you say Conan. Conan. He's a barbarian.
Conan the Barbarian.
That's the only Conan I know. All right.
Yeah.
But,
shout
you
out
know,
to
like,
the game Brawl Force.
Shit, there's
you know?
A lot of people. People, I'm excited. I'm still off topic. But I'm excited for Stephen Colbert coming to the late night show because for he announced his lineup for the next 2 weeks.
Wait. Stephen Colbert's going to late night?
Yeah, that's why he left the Colbert Report.
Oh, wait. What happens? What's happening to Jimmy Fallon then?
No. He's replacing somebody.
Nah, if it's Jimmy... Jimmy Fallon.
Oh, wait. No. Jimmy Fallon's on Tonight Show. He's replacing, what's his face?
Isn't it,
The guy from SNL. Mike Myers. No, not Mike
There are
Myers.
A lot of those.
Mike Myers.
Mike Myers.
Oh,
Mike
yeah,
Mike's
baby.
Here.
You know, at this point, we should have just done TTV Talks about late-night television.
Yeah,
well, I mean, I don't really... Like, I haven't
I
watched it yet.
That.
I don't know what it... Okay, here. Oh, no, yeah, it's Letterman. He's replacing Letterman. Because Letterman left. Remember they had that finale?
Oh!
Yeah.
Am I thinking of then?
I have no clue what you're talking about. All I heard was Mike Myers.
It's American
Jimmy
TV.
Fallon.
Letterman. Oh, no, okay. You said late night, but it's the late show, right?
Late show
and late night are two different shows.
Right, you're right. I completely got it. Well, I mean, he's in late night television.
Seth Meyers is who I was thinking of. Not Mike Myers.
Man,
Seth Meyers.
That guy is like, he's the unappreciated, like, middle child. Like, I remember, it was like, there's Kimmel, there's Conan, there's Jimmy Fallon, and then there's like, Seth Myers.
Between.
I forgot about
him. No one likes Seth Meyers, but he's not that bad. I enjoyed him on SNL a lot.
He's not bad. He's just there.
Yeah, he's
like a middle
there,
child.
Poor guy.
Yeah.
I remember that I actually tried to model one of our segments off of a thing that he did in SNL. And it was going to be called, What the Heck with the Dude-a-Dudes?
Yes.
It was meant to parody, because they do this thing on, or they used to do this thing in SNL, where they would, like, read out, like, news headlines and stuff, and it was really funny. And they would keep repeating, like, their catchphrase. That's what the heck was supposed to be. It was supposed to be Meso going around and, like, just talking about, like, upsetting things in the Bionicle community and continuously re-saying, I mean, what the heck? what the heck is this? And that kind of thing.
I can imagine Meso doing that. It's hilarious.
No, I can't, because he didn't do that.
Yeah, what the heck? Dude, he was kind of like, let's whine about something.
Yeah. It was supposed to be comedy.
It was supposed to be comedy, completely and we were just like, yeah, Meso took it like 100% seriously.
It's not so much that I took it serious, it's more that I didn't think repeating what the heck would be funny.
Oh my goodness, it that's taking shit, the quality
you
standard
also,
of
you
humor.
You also weren't
in your
fast
hand.
Enough about
yes,
it.
Yes, I was very
you
slow.
Were really, your delivery was so bad.
I was like, I think we have one of the best episodes on record. Maybe I'll play it sometime. But it was the one where I talked about the stars, and it was so bootleg.
That was probably the best one. That's the only one I can remember.
That's the only one I remember.
That's the only one I remember either. It was like, there's something with BZ Powers, like some controversy with BZ Powers. You know, Hero Factory versus Bionicle. And how Fear Factor killed Bionicle.
It was like pre-autopsy without flashy
but
visual
it was trying
effects
to be funny.
Or yeah, good, well, or any good
no,
aspects
it was
whatsoever.
Never meant to be funny, I don't think. It was literally the whine about stuff segment.
You know,
well, my vision of it was to be funny, and I told Meso to follow that, and he didn't go with it.
So. Not even
okay. Okay. I've always wanted to do something like Have I Got News For You when I look at like Bionicle news and then just what? Like make fun of it. Which is, it's
that?
An English
Elaborate.
Show with, I can't remember his
news
name. I think it's like, I can't remember his name now. It, like, dropped out of my head. But yeah, it's basically, he looks at recent British news, or even American news, and he basically makes fun of it. It's funny.
Give us a sample. Pick
no,
a piece
no,
of news.
How's about we just keep going?
Bionicle
well, like, let's just say Prince Philip says something inappropriate. He does an impression of him on the stage, or something.
What's his name again?
News for you.
News
the
for
show's
you.
Called Have I Got News For You.
Oh. Is it like Discount John Oliver? Is that what it is?
I don't know
that's
who
that
is.
That's what it sounds like.
It sounds like. It sounds like that. I like John Oliver. I'm not going
to
lie.
Say, I mean, it sounds
I really
like practically
do like
every
him.
Comedian out there now.
Well, okay. But. Hey, here's the thing about Colbert that I was really admiring. So, you know, like the guests they have on late night talk shows, usually like celebrities or music stars. That's basically who they have on. His lineup... for the first week, it does include like there's a rapper and some, you know, an actress, and but he also has Elon Musk. He has a CEO of another company, and he has a Supreme Court justice and some other people, and so and yeah, United States Secretary General. So I'm interested in that because it's like it's this prime time show late night where, you know, a lot of people see these, and he's interviewing people that actually like. Have more importance than celebrities. Not just celebrities. You know, it's like it's CEOs. It's, you know, people in politics. I think that's like fascinating. That he's first week he's like getting all these people, you know, to do his show. So anyhow, I'm excited to see what that show will be.
Nice.
How
he. Changing gears ever so slightly. You guys were talking about, you know, what the heck with the Dudes and how we did things back in the old days. We're no longer the Three Virtues.
That is something we should mention.
Yeah, I was going to say, we mentioned on Meso, we changed. We finally did it. We talked about rebranding a while back, and we did it on everything
you're
but
absolutely
a channel.
Right. Yeah. We did that last night. I completely forgot to mention it. Right.
Yeah. And wait, what? I kind of made notice of this, but it's been 5 years. We were the Three Virtues for 5 years.
We changed officially to Kuma. We changed our channel title officially to the TTV channel.
Yeah, like our username that shows up.
Oh,
yeah, obviously,
I no,
didn't
on
even,
YouTube.
On YouTube, I thought we did that ages ago.
Well, yeah, the logic was we wanted.
we've been the Three Virtues, all one word underscore or not underscore.
We wanted to change it to the.
Oh, so like the.
We wanted to change.
I think I understand now. We were calling ourselves TTV, but the actual like URL.
No, the URL still has not changed.
Yeah, it was always
the
Three
Virtues. Title for the channel. When you post comments, it'll be like, "Oh, Three Virtues next." But now it's just the TTV channel because we wanted to change to the TTV podcast. But then our channel kind of exploded beyond being just a podcast. And we wanted to...
Yeah, I'm kind of glad we never actually fully changed the TTV podcast, because that wouldn't have really made a lot of sense at this point in time.
Right.
Yeah.
Here's the next question. Are we going to change the URL? Because we can do that, I think.
I want to.
I think that's a different thing that we can do later.
We can like start redirecting. We can at least buy the URL, the TTV channel now.
How's about,
and then redirect it to TTV podcast.
Let's give it another 5 years.
What? Another 5 years? Okay, sure.
Okay, yeah.
if we're even still around after another 5 years.
Hey, no, no.
Hate to be pessimistic here.
No, you don't.
We'll be fine.
I really do.
Okay, the one thing I dislike right now about the thing is that if you search the TTV channel on YouTube, it'll say, "Did you mean the TV channel?"
And you have to I know, right?
It's so annoying when that does that.
I know, right?
So,
oh, I didn't think about that.
Get it right. Yeah.
But, I mean, we are the second option, so.
Well, it usually comes up with, like, if when I type in TTV, it usually comes up with Bionicle or podcast.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I've got a bone to pick with all these other TTV channels out there, though.
The, what, like,
what is this? This Nungjing TV? What is this? Nungjing TV. Why does their avatar have TTV in it?
What?
Your channel is Nungjing TT, or Nungjing TV. That starts with an N, not a T.
Well,
why are you taking your T?
We don't know what it is in Korean. Or is it Korean?
Is it Korean?
I have no clue.
I'm pretty sure that's
Korean. That is not that's Korean or Japanese. I've got no clue what that is.
It might be just traditional Chinese.
Doesn't even look Asian.
It's Asian.
Maybe it's new.
Time for Google Translate.
It's 100% Asian.
Go to Google Translate.
It's Chinese. It's Chinese. It's Chinese.
We're both looking at Nanjing, right?
Yeah, yeah. Well, I assume we are. It says TTV in the logo, right? Like it has.
Yeah, it says
thing.
TTV in the logo, but the actual channel is called Nungjing.
No, I don't.
Thai.
Well, it has
it's
Chinese characters.
Thai.
For me.
Like I'm not talking about TTV. Oh. TTV official channel. There's another one.
As in Thailand.
Oh, you're talking about a different one.
Yeah, Nungjing
okay.
TV.
Never mind. Never mind.
Okay.
I don't even see that. I literally don't see that at all. It's not showing up for me.
Okay. It's the same one, right? It's the same one. Yeah, it's the same one. Yeah. I was like, are you sure you're looking at the same one?
Well, okay, you're right.
No.
I was because it has TTV in the logo too, and it's in
yeah, but that's a different one.
Yeah, okay. All right.
I'll link Nungjing to you.
Link that to me then, because I
have no clue what language this is, but it doesn't look Asian to me.
It's Thai, as in Thailand.
So fast, trigger word, bionicle.
Yep.
Right, continue.
Don't worry, guys, we do
what's
have
a bionicle?
We're getting to it.
Okay. Oh, hang on, let me correct that. Star Wars.
Yeah, that's much better. Bionicle's dead.
Okay.
Ouch.
Bionicle should
Ouch.
Be canceled again
Come on,
if they
man.
Should pour the budget.
Okay, yeah, this is an interesting language.
Yeah, what the heck is that?
I think it must be Thai.
I remember seeing Russian and having the exact same reaction.
Bao Zheng at the White Dragon Horse at the end. Bao Zheng is now a part of this sector if the opportunity would come again. Or team will take out the old air instead. Let's see if there is a call for air much. Or to put it another
airing.
What is this
I'm
episode?
I'm pretty sure he's watching. Yeah, that's
why. That's just for Google Translate.
Internet surfing with TTV.
Yep.
So if I found this funny cat meme the other day on Surf the Internet talking about cat memes.
Holy crap, Thai is a weird language. I have never seen that before in my life.
I find it interesting. Like,
I actually know someone from Thailand.
We do too.
We all do.
Yeah, so do we.
Yeah.
Hey.
Not from, but
not
there.
The same person.
He lived there for a while.
Rip.
Yeah.
That was a pain.
I know someone native.
Okay.
Man, it would just take us an entire episode to look back and just reminisce.
Well, I figure we do that. We'll do that eventually again.
We'll do
yeah,
that
we'll do that
our
200th
which,
episode.
Gotta say,
five.
Didn't do any celebration, but thank you very much for 20,000 subscribers. It's a momentous occasion.
Are we gonna do? Are we gonna do something
Probably,
for 25?
Let's do 25.
Yeah,
25.
That's
sense.
Like a quarter of the way.
Right, 25 guys. We'll figure it out.
I think 25 is a better
increment.
25
is better than 25.
That being said, thank you nonetheless.
Yeah.
It's a momentous occasion.
Yeah.
Vessel's doing well. The YouTube channel's doing well. Everything's doing well.
It's like that moment when you come to realize that there's not even, like, in the place where I live, there isn't even 20,000 people that live here. I'm like, whoa!
Nice.
Yeah, no. Everything is going really well.
Yep.
Right, it's a good time to be
surprisingly well. Yeah, I'm really happy with where TTV is right now.
I gotta
thank all the audience out there.
I was gonna say it's all thanks to you guys.
Everything's
going
real well.
Thanks to us for doing work too. But
wow,
we had like we had
is that a Rick and Morty joke?
I don't watch it.
Yeah.
Wait, who are we talking to?
Sort of Eljay when he was like turn off the simulation.
Yeah, in fact, well, I mean, there's something on the boards that referenced something you guys talked about on the Fantastic Four TTV Talks that I posted.
I linked in the chat.
That? Fantastic.
Oh,
that.
Oh, I forgot. I forgot I was on that episode.
Yeah.
That episode was funny.
That came out like, or not came out, but it was like
a couple weeks ago.
Right after my week or 2 weeks up from the podcast.
That bottom picture. What the heck?
All right, let's not talk about this unless we are going to plan on putting it in the video.
I'll put it in the video. But okay, go on. Stupid car! Go on.
I'm convinced Meso's schizophrenic and he just hears
Bionicle.
Well, I just remembered, you know, in the...
Because I can hear it.
Viper! You've ruined the joke!
Why would you back him up? Why would you do that? You're such a terrible person.
Of course, we can all hear it!
So I'm gonna throw a couple people under the bus here.
No, you mean the car?
What?
I'm preparing to commit to bus throwing right now. I'm also going to date this video at the time of
you're
this
video. You're going to date a video?
At the time of this video.
What's happening to you,
sexuality. Did the Supreme Court authorize that, huh? Are they coming to arrest you for doing your job?
At the time of this recording, it's September 5th.
Don't do this.
Eljay and Viper haven't read the book.
Oh, okay, that's
the, oh yeah,
that's it.
I've been busy.
Wait, okay, you're giving me crap for not doing the book yesterday, and Eljay hasn't done it. Isn't that Eljay's whole shtick is being the Bionicle guy?
Have you done it?
We already know everything in the book. I'm not required to do this at the moment.
Takuma.
Yeah, you are! You're doing a show! You literally
sat in Paul of yelling at me. It's like, it's literally your job to read the book.
Talk to me about. You're excluding me.
We told you
yesterday
about it.
We
had a business meeting about it.
It's nice to know you have selective hearing, though.
What?
Takuma, what about you? Have you read it?
What?
Have you read it?
I mean, at least I've read more than LJ.
Have you read it?
I mean, I lurk on Reddit, but I don't really post much.
Reddit lurking.
I'll take that as a no. You're all dead to me.
I mean, nobody is dead.
I literally read the book in one sitting. It was an hour read.
There's no reason it should take this long.
I don't know, maybe I have ADD
morning,
and I'm bored
in
5 minutes.
It's hard when I don't have the book.
Listen, there is no excuse in this day and age. Here's how I bought my book. I don't have a Kindle, I have a PC. I got web Kindle, I clicked pre-order, and the book was delivered to me at midnight. And I read
What's
it
your
in
point?
An hour.
In your this, point's that, that you,
like,
come on, you can buy the book
last
literally
I checked,
right now.
I'm not,
on
sure, I'm not sure, LJ, whether, have you even ordered it yet?
So, yeah, I ordered mine from my Kindle, but it says it's going
to
take until
right
it's going
to
take until November for it to be delivered. I'm like, this isn't an actual delivery, silly. This is a Kindle delivery.
Yeah,
silly.
LJ, have you even ordered it yet?
Yeah, here, I'll explain my rationale here.
I don't want to know your rationale. I want to know if you've ordered it yet. Yes or no?
Yeah, you guys have an issue.
In
of
case
not
you haven't noticed, rationale
is
yes
or
no. So.
I've ordered it in the future.
Wow!
more Terminator references. We need to.
All right,
LJ, I'm cutting your salary.
Every single discussion we've had about the books, you've always said, "How could you not get the books?" Like you're always like, "How could you not read the books in the original Bionicle
line?" Books.
I freaking read the book. Why haven't you read the book?
Okay, here's my rationale here.
Probably the same reason he hasn't been reviewing the recent set.
Oh, I knew that was happening! I knew you were going to say that. You're going to bring this up eventually. Anyway, no, here's the thing. I want to have a hard copy. I have all the other Bionicle books in hard copy. I want to have this one in hard copy as well. I can get it on Kindle, but I'm waiting on the necessary funds at the right time in certain bank accounts to order something so I can make a bulk purchase.
Yeah.
And then I'll order the book. Unfortunately, things have been turbulent. I haven't been able to get the stars to align. But when they do, which is going to be today, I will order it today.
Wait. Okay.
My explanation is much shorter and to the point.
Why do you need
the unemployed.
Bulk order? Are you going to order
$5? Do you not have $5?
You can't get like a ton of. Are you gonna buy a ton of Bionicle books? Is that
what you're doing?
Shipping? Yeah. What are you doing?
Well, no. I'm gonna buy a ton of other things.
Yeah, you probably wanted to pile stuff
He's gonna
together
buy
on Amazon
a
to get like free shipping.
Why don't you just
why?
Why?
What's why the not? Point?
FIFA doesn't freaking have Prime.
Well, no,
I
actually,
forgot people don't have Prime.
Actually,
oh.
I do.
You do? Okay, no.
Well, then
you have no excuse.
Why would you buy in bulk then?
Literally, there's no excuse.
There's no difference. It's shipping's free.
So I could just get a bunch of things all at once.
You want to waste our time so that you can get a big freaking box of useless junk in the mail?
No, I'm the one that's trying to talk for a series that
you guys haven't talked to me about. What the? Why? They don't. You know that Amazon doesn't ship you a giant box, right? They're gonna send you a bunch of little packages of everything you've ordered. They come in separate packages.
Yeah, they're not gonna send you a Kahi box that's absolutely massive.
But they all get here on the
Christmas
same
time.
Day.
It's not like they ship you
Christmas
one
time.
Box.
Okay, okay,
and
I'm doing it.
Amazon will package everything and they'll send it to you.
Got no books this year.
On TTV, I'm going to order this book. I'm going to make this a spectacle because you guys have dragged me through the mud.
You've already made it a spectacle.
Deservingly so.
Well, a moment ago, Meso was trying to throw us all under a car,
I don't get that.
Meso was trying to throw a car.
What did you think was going? They're not going to ship you everything at the same time. They're going to ship you at 2 days, like everything in different packages, 2 days from when you order it.
Okay.
If you order the Bionicle book now, there's literally no difference if you have Prime.
Here's the thing. I would absolutely order this book right now. But I forgot the password to Amazon.
Just do it.
Oh, my.
Okay. We're done.
Okay. And now I'm seriously considering cutting your salary.
We're done.
Hang
here.
On. That's not my fault.
Listen.
You don't have your own Amazon account?
We're
gonna wind up with at least three people crying by the end of this episode, aren't we?
I just
are you crying tears of joy.
This is not an account.
I pick LJ, Meso, and Var.
This isn't an account I use very often. It's just not.
It's just not.
Okay, then reset your freaking password.
Okay, I'm sorry.
We're making a new account.
What is your
problem?
Why can't you do this?
I thought you were an adult. Why are we paying you?
I'm so sorry.
I feel really bad now for laughing
you're
at all this.
I don't
feel bad. You should feel bad because you're in the wrong
boat. Now let's laugh at him about his lack of reviews.
No.
Hey, no. If you're laughing at me for my lack of reviews, where's Showcase Var?
Yeah, where's Protector of Fire and Protector of Ice?
Well, I did see a picture of them on the milk this morning.
Var didn't say anything. Let's be quiet until Var answers. Everybody be quiet until Var says something.
I haven't done it. I'm not the one getting on your case about the reviews.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's also true.
So I don't know what you're getting on my case for. I'm also in the wrong here.
Well, no. It's not exactly that I'm getting on your case. I'm just trying to redirect Meso getting on people's case.
I don't know why care about Meso.
Because Meso doesn't have a show. Meso edits TTV Podcast.
It's just so I need a little bit of breathing room. That's it.
Listen, I don't give a crap about your breathing room. I don't
give
a crap about Meso.
Gosh, Meso's is this going to be relationships part 3?
I don't need
LJ,
we're
breaking up.
We need some space.
We all need some blank space.
Blank space, baby.
Oh my.
Guys, TTV is over.
Yeah.
I was going to say, wasn't it just a couple minutes ago, Bard's like, we're really happy with where TTV is at right now.
No, we are really happy where TTV is at. We're not happy where LJ's at.
Yeah.
That's what we're not
LJ
happy
needs
with.
LJ needs like a quality check.
Dude, if I had known you didn't do any of his stuff, I wouldn't have read the first.
You know what? I'm gonna do one better. I'm not only going to order the book. I'm gonna pre-order everything else. All the other books.
I don't. What other book? Who cares? Just get the book that's out right now,
so we can talk about it. I'm just saying. So this way, it doesn't happen in the future. No. This way, it doesn't happen in the future. I'll have them all pre-ordered, and we'll be all good.
Fair enough.
I thought you said you had it pre-ordered last time.
Yeah,
no,
didn't you
I
say
didn't.
You had it pre-ordered?
I was notably one of the ones that didn't have it pre-ordered last time. I hate pre-orders.
I hate you.
I hate them too, but we're not going to not buy the Bionicle book. There's some stuff
I'm not going to not buy it. Of course I'm going to buy it.
I mean, it's just kind of a thing where like, hey, this is our business goes around talking about the Bionicle story as it's come out in the book. Just why wouldn't you just buy the book? I bought the book. I didn't read it until today, and that's I'll be.
I know.
Front
I'm
and this is coming
but,
from Kahi, someone who
yeah,
hates
I
books.
Yeah, no, I don't hate books. I just
well,
don't
you,
like
it's
buying
me,
kids
is that
books.
We railed on Kahi last night for not reading the book, but at least he had it purchased. I didn't know you didn't have it purchased. What is your problem?
What's your problem for not knowing, Var? Where have you been?
You are going to pull.
Now this is the question of the day.
You are going to try and pull that. Shut up, my
friend. Isn't that the question of the day?
Viper, the adults are talking. Stay out of this.
Stay out of this danger hunt.
I wasn't going to say that.
Eljay, as we've established, you were clearly not an adult, so first of all...
I'm running away from home.
I'm sorry, okay? It's one time.
One time.
He wants to run away from TTV home with me.
All right.
No, but really, guys, read the frickin' book.
Yeah.
You almost made me cuss again.
Until then, I've read the book. Animations to talk about.
Can we talk about
yes.
the book?
Yes. Oh, thank you,
Eljay.
Beware of their tails.
I'm cutting your pay every week until you read the book.
That, I mean... In part ways, and to fulfill what Eljay's been saying for a while, I feel like Lee was the only real character in the book, and everybody else is the same character.
Thank you.
What?
But like in terms of like dialogue and how they act, I don't feel
perhaps in the speech patterns. Yeah,
in the speech patterns. Not necessarily in their personalities.
I think Pohatu's got a pretty unique personality.
Yeah, Pohatu and Lua.
See, I would say Anua is the closest one outside of
my favorites.
I feel Anua has his own.
Yeah,
I think all of them have well-defined personalities, except for Tahu and Kopaka.
Yeah, I wouldn't say well-defined.
They all.
I wouldn't say well-defined either, but I would definitely say
and they all.
They are how. Yeah. Well, okay,
I don't know about Anua. I definitely think Pohatu has a personality, and I think Liwa has a personality.
Yeah.
I don't know about any of the others. The others are all the same.
Yeah, I think Gali and Tahu and Kopaka are probably the worst.
I'd say Tahu and Kopaka.
You haven't read the book.
Fun.
How would you know?
I was just talking about in general.
What do you mean? We're not talking in general. We're talking about the book.
Well, that's my opinion, and
it's an uninformed
you didn't read
opinion.
The book.
Well, I read half of the book.
Oh,
well, you know,
I think
the Black Panther wasn't really well done in Civil War. I think they could have done a bit more of his character in Civil War.
She has a point.
You don't have your point.
Don't you even dare.
The point is you didn't order the book.
If you want to get technical, I've also read half the book too off of Amazon preview.
May I say something? May I say something?
Yes.
Sure,
Takuma.
I just spent 30 seconds buying the book.
Nice. You go to Takuma.
Wow. Takuma, you're getting a raise. Actually, no, you're not because it should have been done a week ago.
Eljay, so did you?
I'm unemployed.
Yeah, well, that was your decision. You could have been unemployed.
Okay. Not my decision.
Wow. No, is that what you say to like all the homeless people too, Mark? That was your decision.
they're out on a bench with an old guitar trying to earn some cash. I lost my home. I lost my dog. I lost my life. Yeah, that was your decision.
Yeah, well, that was your decision.
VAR is not even on the side of should we raise minimum wage? Should we not raise minimum wage? VAR's like, no, let's lower it.
Listen,
we should get rid of minimum wage. I think minimum wage is kind of a... Anyhow.
Don't start. Do not do this.
So, we're not gonna...
Anything that lowers the wages of all of our employees, I'm all for it.
I feel like we should get more, like you said,
on the message boards, our channel is like a Chinese sweatshop.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's like a Chinese
sweatshop if we had no control over any of the kids working in our sweatshop.
It's like, you know, if LJ was in a Chinese sweatshop, he'd be blinded for not getting the book on time. He'd be like those kids in Daredevil.
Yeah, I was about to say, I could be Daredevil.
No.
No.
Shut
no,
up.
You, no, you wouldn't.
The kid in Daredevil. Or you're not Daredevil. You're the kid that gets shot in the face.
Spoiler alert.
The Chinese novel.
Spoilers! Get down!
I mean, that show has shot in that show.
People
there you
die.
Go. Spoilers.
We've
people
got
die.
Like three episodes
nobody
of
died.
Bionicle that
don't
we haven't spoken about on air.
People definitely died, Takuma.
Shh. How do you guys think the Bionicle animations have been progressing?
I don't want to talk about Bionicle.
I do want to talk about Bionicle a bit.
You're the one who brought up the stupid
so
kids getting
when,
killed.
When Tahu and Kopaka meet up, this is the conversation that goes. Tahu goes, I'm the leader. And Kabaka's like, no, you're not. And they literally start fighting immediately. Like, I was reading the book and I was like, what?
So what you're saying is VAR and Meso.
Well, I mean, they reach every, they, like, imagine these two people meet together for the first time, and everyone's sitting there, and Tyler's like, hey guys, I guess I'm the leader, and Tupac's like, no you're not, and then they literally jump at each other, and they start punching each other.
I mean, that's
and
the problem with
the
book,
floor.
I guess. That's what happened in the animations.
That's hilarious.
And that's what happened in the book, which shouldn't happen in the book. We should get more insight in the book.
I don't know anything about that particular scene in the book, but
you're
in the
right.
animations, I think...
Give me some slack. I'm trying to
contribute. No! If I didn't get any slack, you're not getting any slack.
But you're getting slack. You're getting tons of it.
He
like,
did, he got. He's getting slack because he finally read the book.
Yeah, I did
I don't
my
even
thing.
Own slack.
I bought it and I read it.
I've got some decent dress pants, though.
This conversation is so impossible to follow.
I know. I'm just sat there listening.
Like. Yeah, it's like Tahu and Kopaka are fighting. Pants.
Yeah.
No. Yeah. See, the one thing that like I don't get it. That's my biggest complaint about the book is like I don't understand
pants?
Why it follows the anime.
All right, Takuma.
Takuma. I don't understand why it follows the animation so closely. We've got a freaking book here. We should be able to have more dialogue and more information.
I can only surmise it was because at the point of the book's inception, the 2015 story was like they had the animation outlines and nothing else, so we just kind of followed off that.
Well, no, the dialogue basically. I know Merlin Mann when he wrote all the descriptions, and I think the dialogue is almost exactly the same.
Yeah, pretty much. It's almost exactly the same.
Well, that's what I'm saying.
Hey,
it's
by
like
the way,
for the first part of the animations, they were already out, and Ryder Windham was able to like kind of do his own thing. But the summer animations weren't out at the inception of this book, so he probably just had to follow it more closely. He didn't have as much room for creative freedom.
I don't know. I wouldn't say that. I would say that
Ryder
Windham wrote his book like a long time before.
I don't know.
You know, and he was told to do one thing. And with like the beginning of the Protectors is not seen in the animation, so that's why I feel that's the strongest point in the book. Maybe because it's just something new, or maybe because he's able to have a bit more creative freedom.
Definitely,
the next
creative freedom,
the trials and trails of Bing, Zack, and Friends.
Book. Well, I mean, it's not that. I mean, the animations, you know, well, we follow Merlin really well. I think they're pretty well written for, you know, the 30-second animations that they are.
About as well written as they can be under
yeah.
the circumstances.
Well, yeah. See, like, well, yeah, under the circumstances of the book. The 30-second animation, like, or not 30-second, it's like, what, 90 seconds?
Yeah, 90 seconds.
The 90-second animation, you know, all that, you have to be really concise in how you write and, you know, convey all that humor and everything as, you know, in that span of time. And you don't need to do that with a book, but the book basically follows those animations to the letter.
Yeah.
And I feel like that's a bit of a disservice to the medium. I think there's
different
mediums.
Yeah, it's very disappointing.
Different things.
I do gotta say, though, about the... Well, I'll let you first.
I was just gonna say it because it makes certain things just not make any sense here. Like, because Kahi mentioned how Tahu and Kopaka started fighting. Like, well, first of all, why did Tahu even have the assumption that he was the leader to begin with?
Because he was red.
Because he's arrogant.
Like, I guess, but we weren't told that. He just showed up first time meeting these guys,
yeah.
and he's just like, "Hey guys, I'm the leader."
This would be the
and
medium
Kapaka's
to
like,
get that introspection.
Right, it would be, but we didn't.
Nope.
Right.
And Kopaka's just like, no, you're not, and then they just start fighting. Like, what's happening right now?
Right.
What's going on?
Like, Kopaka, I mean, I'm not always a fan of drawing back to G1 comparisons, but I did like Kopaka and Tahu's dynamic and how they spoke as characters were really different in the original because, you know, Tahu was abrasive and forward as a toe of fire, and Kopaka was, you know, he was more reserved and cold. When they both talk to each other in the book, they sound like the same character.
Yep.
They shouldn't sound like the same character. Kopaka, I mean, he can still mean the same thing, you know, but he should be, I feel he should be a bit more stoic about it.
I do not,
unfortunately,
I do not like
that's G1 Kopaka. I get it.
Unfortunately, yeah, it seems like they've really changed Kopaka's character a lot in that aspect because it seems like Pohatu is basically what Kopaka was.
Yeah, they probably
right.
have
a... And I like original Kopaka. I like the kind of like you Batman. Did. Well, he didn't really do a ton of Batman-y stuff, but they should have like picked that up and made him part of that character.
I agree.
I
it's
know,
like,
man.
I am all for changing the characters of people to fit the interpretation of this new Bionicle, but it feels like they took away his stoic personality and replaced it with nothing.
Yeah, I feel
like he's like
the weakest.
Knock off Tahu.
He's like
yeah.
less
Tahu
angry
Kopaka,
Tahu. It's like Tahu if he wasn't yelling all the time.
It's Tahu on drugs. He's like Tahu, but he's a bit of a stoner, so he's a little more mellow at times.
Like, I feel like Kopaka should have been like the polar opposite of the polar opposite of Tahu.
You're so funny.
I get it, because we have ice in, anyway.
Ice and fire.
Nice. But another comment I wanted to make about the animation.
But no, it's like,
at least, I don't know about you guys, but the past couple animations I felt have not actually been all that bad.
No, they've been great.
I've liked.
What do you mean all that bad? I've loved all the animations.
You know what I mean? Yeah, we're not going to get into that.
Come on.
As soon as they regrouped, I don't know.
We've already had a clip show.
Okay, all right.
I didn't mind
the clip show.
Oh yeah, the full on Towers thing was really disappointing. Because
I didn't mind that a bit. The clip show was a little bit like, all right, you know. I mean, I get the budget probably.
Yeah,
made
like,
that
I get
happen.
It, but it's just.
Well, it's like I actually really liked that scene in the book because I thought it was like it was important to actually have the Toa just kind of talk to one another about their goal. I feel like how it translated into the animations, the clip show was just a backdrop, so it wasn't them talking to each other nonstop, just kind of cutting back and forth for the whole episode. It was the dialogue that was important. It was them just kind of reinforcing their mission.
Yeah, you
it's the
correct.
First time they've had a discussion about their mission since they all met.
Yeah. I
now,
appreciate
really, it's
that.
It's
that
the discussion that they should have had at the start when they introduced each other.
Instead of fighting.
Yeah, instead of fighting like morons.
Yeah. Those were pretty dumb.
Stupid you know, car. Okay. That is a comment I have to make real quick. I hate how the Toa charge at everything.
They're dumb.
Without
They're
any
very dumb.
Modicum of unity or strategy
they
or tactics.
They are very gung-ho,
well,
like,
I mean,
Toa.
That's what happens you read later on in the book. Spoilers. But what happens is that, like, they all...
Don't spoil.
Nope.
Don't spoil.
I don't want to hear it.
Yeah.
No. Just be like... Listen. That is, I understand why they're so dumb and charged at everything, though, because that's part of the actual growth of their characters right now.
I was going
to
say...
The only growth we're getting right now.
Yeah.
To be fair, there is a distinct difference in... the first and second generation in that as far as the second generation's concerned, we don't know where they've come from or what their lives were leading up to this point.
Where did they go?
In the first one, there was this whole bit about them being trained for this grand purpose and everything.
True.
Yeah.
Yeah, but we kind of have to assume that they're trained in some aspect because we know they're ancient heroes that were
already... Well, yeah, you kind of would. I'm just saying
everybody
we
knows
don't
about
know
them, yeah.
anything
lose,
about
everyone
their
knows
past.
Them.
Like, Tahu can instinctively fight, but they've lost their memories, so they've lost their memories of working as a team, so they have to learn that. However,
well,
I feel like...
You could, well, at that point, you can say that's muscle memory, whereas tactics aren't, you know, those are something...
Well, yeah,
that actually...
that's exactly what's happening. Like, they've got their muscle memory, they can instinctively fight, they know their moves, like charging and that kind of thing, but they don't understand how to use those effectively and tactically.
I mean,
like they should,
which is what I'm getting at.
Animation-wise, it's still kind of unusual that they're going about this whole charging thing because we've already seen them work cohesively together to defeat Loss.
That was my problem. It doesn't feel like character growth. It feels like let's rehash the same thing three times because they did it with Loss.
I guess,
let's
but
get-
it's not like you. It's not like you just get it the first time. Like they got it once,
you know,
and I think there's I think there's still room to improve after that point. Like they figured it out one time, they understand that that's a thing that they can do, but they still haven't solved the issue that none of them really get along right now, and they still aren't that united. They united in one fight, but that doesn't mean they're going to be united from now on in every other fight.
True. I get that.
True.
They're aware now
sense,
that they can do it, but the trouble is getting to that point.
Right, exactly. They still need to get to that, where that's part of their tactic.
The way it's written, and then maybe this is just the way the plot is, and they had to write around that, but the way it's presented, though, is that it's the same thing. Like, you don't see what they learned from the last time and a fraction that applies to now, where someone's like, you know, where they have to learn to unite, but in a different way. Or they, you know, they remember the previous experience. It's just the same thing repeated, the way it's presented. I get where you're coming from in terms of structure and how that makes sense, but the way it's conveyed to us, the reader, isn't that doesn't shine through.
I mean, then again, they also repeated this whole unity thing with Skull Slicer, didn't they?
Yeah, they did. Did Skull? No, they do it with Basher.
Yeah, the things Grindr. I'm thinking of are Scorpio and Basher.
Like, when they all charge at once, get knocked down, and then they're like, oh, wait a minute, unity. Oh, yeah, that was a thing.
But it's funny, because they all charged at once, unitedly, so.
They actually did fight Slicer very well.
Yeah, they fought Slicer together, like...
Kind of.
Yeah, I don't think they had any issue with fighting Slicer.
a slice.
Well, I mean, I guess Onua did almost get killed, but Kapaka saved him.
Yeah, you're so, welcome.
Well, yeah, that's true, and Kapaka almost got the chance to punch Tahu in the face, so...
Yeah,
yeah, and also they told Onua to charge, so it's not like he was just charging on his own.
Yeah.
It's like, so it was still
working together, yeah.
True fact.
Yeah, and like we said with the hostage situation, like, Slicer had... Tahu, was like, Tahu, you're in my way! And he ducked down and punched him in the face. That was my favorite bit of that entire thing.
Yeah. See, I don't know, to me it makes sense that the Towers are so silly, so stupid, and they've lost all their memories.
Haphazard.
Yeah, because, I mean, it's just like they've kind of forgotten who they were and how to be mature, that kind of thing. It's like they've regressed back in time.
It's like they...
For all we know, this...
is cool.
For all we know, they may have never even met each other before. Just saying.
That is true.
Yeah. That's
well,
valid.
They also seem to know that, like, they're supposed to be... Well, I guess they're told that.
Hopefully we'll get some elaboration on this eventually, and that it won't always be left ambiguous.
Yeah.
Slash.
You know, I am... The thing about it is that the next book, when it comes out, is going to be purely what's in that book. Like, it's not going to be an adaptation of everything. I'm glad we didn't have a thing where this book only covered the first...
Yeah, we don't know that because we don't know the animations are going to stop with just this year.
I hope they don't.
No,
I really
no. I want the animation to continue. I guess the other book, isn't it coming out in like October,
December,
or December? Well, I guess it could carry on.
I don't think it will because it's about skull spiders, but it could conceivably tell something.
Well, the first half could be.
I would enjoy it to be a side story that is used to flesh out.
I want longer animations. I want longer animations
same.
With a bigger budget.
I want.
I don't mind. I love the animations, but I would love if they were longer. If they were longer, that's all I asked for. I don't need like a.
I understand the short format, but I feel like a minute 30 seconds is too short. I think 10 minutes is being YouTubers and us being in the whole internet. Video platform, I think 10 minutes is the sweet spot that I wish they would aim for.
And hey, let's also be fair.
Even if it was just 5 minutes.
Animation does take a while.
Yeah.
And
it does.
It takes, and it's like, I think the main thing is not that nobody in the Bionicle team didn't want to do that. They just didn't have the budget for it.
That's what I'm saying. I just wish that Lego would give it.
We're not appealing to the Bionicle team. We're appealing to corporate. We're like, hey, corporate, give us, you know. If you invest in Bionicle, it should come back and pay. Like, look at how Ninjago's paid off.
One day, I would really like to know why Bionicle did not get a TV show. Was it because too much of their money is tied up in other themes right now that have TV shows and they just
they have Ninjago
it?
And they used to have Chima.
Or is it because they made a bunch of solid gold masks instead?
I think it's because of Hero Factory.
I think Hero Factory really
screwed it over.
Well, you have to also be aware that parents don't, like... The construction figures as a whole might not be a big market, and that might influence their decision as to if they're going to invest a bunch into this Bionicle, you know, the Bionicle coming back. I do think that they could have invested a lot more into, like, relaunching this line again, because it was a huge line in the beginning and it had a huge story focus, and that was a big, like, core thing for anyone who was a fan of that. And they should have been able to be like, oh, people like story, let's devote a large part of its budget to getting this story done. And to get it done on a wider scale, and they have, like, you know, if you look at how, like, TV shows now, kids' TV shows are really good. Gravity Falls,
they are,
Adventure Time, you know.
I mean, if you want to look at one that specifically ties into
Young Justice, all those cartoons are really big, and like, and people, not just them, people outside of that age group. Steven Universe is like meant for kids, but
it's really popular
for a lot of people. Okay. Tapping into that, I get Lego's not a TV show business, but they have to realize that prominence of including that with their brand and, you know, selling the toys.
If you want a perfect example of how it can promote toy sales, you need to look no further than MLP.
Ah, dang it. I was hoping you weren't going to say
My Little Pony.
No, he's right, though.
No, he's
very
right. Valid point.
He's right. I just...
How many of these, like, kind of 30-year-old guys would have bought My Little Pony toy had it not been for that TV show? Basically zero. Yeah, never would have crossed their minds.
Yeah.
You know?
Oh, well. No sense crying over spilled milk. We don't have a TV show.
Well, you're right. I mean, it's not... Well,
I'm saying this sure because I feel like Lego should consider this for the future.
It is ironic that we're mentioning
Lego's not. Right.
It is ironic that we're mentioning all this after just establishing that TV is dead earlier in the podcast.
Yeah, you know that. Well possibly shot us in the foot.
When I say TV show, I mean the TV show.
Yes,
format.
But
in a perfect world, it would be a 22-minute animated TV show with a fully voiced cast that airs online. But that's would never happen.
See,
no,
I think that could happen, and I think it would definitely be successful, but from what I've noticed with Lego is they have no clue how to properly, like, handle a channel and
online
monetize online videos.
Right. The online distribution, especially the release schedule for Lego, is not universal across all
and that's the big issue. They need to really step up monetization of their videos and make sure they crack down on, like, I know it kind of sucks to say this, but I think they do need to crack down on re-uploads of their videos.
Yeah.
I think that's really important for them because they're losing a
lot
of monetary
views
value.
And stuff, yeah.
Everybody re-uploads them for some reason, and I don't really know why.
Yeah.
Yeah,
and
I
they
mean,
really
if it's
should,
on
at the
YouTube,
end of this, they should do a compilation of all of them and
yeah,
stop
that's
like,
what
and get
I was...
all that money.
Like, that's what I was going to say. Yeah. I watched the winter wave animations in bulk, and it's a lot more satisfying at the end because you don't have to wait over a couple
of
weeks.
Oh yeah, totally.
To like see.
I didn't watch episode 13 when it came out, but when I heard that episode 14 was out, I watched both of them back to back, and it was a much more enjoyable.
It's so
experience.
Much more satisfying because you get like the better pace.
And it's funny because like that what you're saying, that's experience anybody's going to have from now on. There's not going to be a thing where anybody's going to have to wait a week from now to get that ever episode.
Yeah, very true.
That's the thing, like, that's why binge watching is so popular, because someone realized after this season has aired, nobody is going to experience it like that ever again. Nobody.
Mm-hmm.
So, that's, I mean,
and also,
you know,
when
I wouldn't say put
all
everything
the animations
up at once.
Together,
but,
it's like, what they say, 20 animations, minute and a half long, that's like 26 minutes in total for the year. That's the length of time, a little over. For a TV special.
Guys, Lego should hire us to handle their YouTube channel.
They should.
Yeah, listen, if everyone really here's watching, we're open to
we are, I mean, like, I know we do stuff, you know, just like
I'm unemployed.
Content creators, but we do a lot of business behind the scenes, too. We've like, looked at analytics. We know how to, like, you know, to
we looked at analytics,
out.
Guys. We saw the percentage number thing.
Well,
we
see, the thing is, not looking at analytics is one thing, but knowing what to do with those analytics, that's another.
Well, I mean, you know, we could at least just say, like, you know, just little tidbits of advice that they should follow. Number one, have everything scheduled to go at the same time in all different
that's
time
the biggest
zones.
Thing. That should be the most obvious.
Right. I don't think, like, you shouldn't, if you want, I guess they could roll it out depending on which country it is in, but then you get this thing where everything's segmented and Russia comes out before English and people are looking at the Russian version first. And it's just, it's better for, I feel it's better for, you know, people as it goes around if all the episodes are released at the same time.
Yeah,
because
it's all synchronized.
Right, if it's all synchronized. Generally, I get why that doesn't work, because you want to release it at the prime time for each market. However, it doesn't work because all the fan bases are already communicating with each other.
Yeah, on a TV platform.
The moment it comes up for Russia, all the English people are going to Russia already.
On the TV platform that works, they did it with Hero Factory 2, where the episodes would air in Russia or some other country, Korea, I
think. Yeah, it makes sense on TV.
Because people are less likely to record and upload it online.
Yeah. Right.
On the internet, though, everything is like fully accessible.
You can't just access Russian TV.
Yeah.
So.
Right.
So,
but on
the internet's...
Right.
Yeah, everyone can go anywhere, so it doesn't work that way. You have to release it all at the same time.
Yeah, and then, it should also come out. It should come out on YouTube. It should come out on Facebook at the same time. I see this happen, like, sometimes, some days after they'll try to put it on Facebook, which is, it's not a bad idea, but by that time, anybody who's interested in sharing that video has already seen it.
It should come out.
Oh, and they need to stop making it public whenever they just upload it, too. Like, it needs to be set to private and then made public when everything is ready.
Yeah,
I keep seeing videos show up on, like, the videos page on Lego.com before it shows up on YouTube, or it'll show up on YouTube before it shows up on Bionicle.com. It's just, it's
too
segmented.
To that degree, however, they know this is an issue. Because, like, a few weeks ago, I think I mentioned this on the podcast, first time ever I saw the YouTube account post a comment in response. It was on one of the episodes on YouTube, and somebody was, like, ripping them because of their release schedule. And they said, yeah, we're going to do this, we're going to work on it, we're going to get it out to you guys, we're working on getting videos out to you guys. And after that, they did get a somewhat shaky but still consistent schedule. We've gotten almost consistently, every 10 days or so, approximately every 10 days, we get an episode.
Yeah, they are definitely better now. Totally. Yeah. It's much better than it was before.
So I think they understand it is an issue, but still hire us. We'll do a great job.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, I think
just
I'm
don't
like,
expect
there's
us to speak Danish.
There's all sorts of like publicity things you can do leading up to it. There's all sorts of ways you can reformatize how you do the episodes and that kind of thing. I feel like it's, you know, Bionicle in 2016, they've had the time to get the budget or get their analytics back, basically. How Bionicle sold and all this stuff, all the how the fans are engaged, all that stuff from 2015. And hopefully by now they're already like making changes to their 2016 schedule based on that information. And hopefully that information is really good so that they'd be like, all right, we're going to give you more money to do this in 2016, or we're going to give you less, or we're going to do this, or do that. You know.
Mm-hmm. Oh, well.
Hopefully.
Yep.
So the animation
we got a big budget. Animation, I like the animations a lot.
I meant the latest one.
Nothing
really
would
good.
Make me happier than if Templar was back doing another game.
I know,
if
right?
If Templar like was back, man, and they did like an app and it was available on iOS, it was you know.
Yes, thank you, Kahi.
So before we end the episode today, LJ, you're not gonna weasel your way out of it. Mention,
what did I do now?
You were all about to forget something important, but thankfully I'm not dumb like you, so I remembered.
Oh.
Talking on your Comic Con.
Yeah. So, long story short, if any of you are gonna be in the Salt Lake area, Salt Lake, Utah, they're having a Comic Con there, September 24th to the 26th. I'm gonna be there. Let me know if you are. We'll meet up. That's it.
Oh yeah, I'm going to New York. So if you guys are going to do that too, then yeah.
Yeah, Kai's going to
New York
Comic
Con.
I'll be at Salt Lake
Comic
Con. Kai will be at New York Comic Con. And if you're going to be in either of those areas around the same point, and you'd like to maybe meet up with either of them, just post in the comments.
Yeah,
post in comments. Tweet at us. Yeah. Tweet at me because I tend to read those more.
Eljay's meetup isn't going to be at the Comic Con though, right? You're going to meet up in like a park.
I'm going to find another place to meet up. I'm going to talk to
that sounds really sketchy.
That's what I said. Sketchy.
He like
can you imagine asking your parents
here's the thing.
To do that?
Can I meet this random guy in the park?
No, don't worry, Mom. We met
on the internet.
It's either
don't forget to bring a bag of free candy.
Oh my gosh. Okay, you know what?
A Subway sandwich.
Fine. We're gonna go right right in front of the convention center.
Oh no.
Yeah,
no.
I guess I'm
you went
foot
there.
Long.
Well, we're so oh dear God.
I think I missed something and I think I'm glad
we're
I did
this for our sins and our transgressions.
Just meet up at a Lego store.
The Lego store's
just,
not happening.
It's weird that you're suddenly against it because you were for it initially.
Yeah, I know I was for it initially. Yada yada yada. Okay, you know what? We're gonna meet right out front of the convention
center. Just do it
center.
In convention. We'll
just
right do it in convention center
with all the cars and the
and
traffic
they,
and everyone trying to get out.
Why are you just doing it in the convention?
Because not everyone can access the convention.
Well, you don't know if everybody will be like they'd have to be there for. Okay, it's just kind of like you know.
I have
we don't even know. We don't even
location.
Know if a meetup is going
to
happen. We don't know if anybody's going
to
be there.
Yeah,
no,
you
just,
need
right,
to decide.
Here's
otherwise, you're going
to
confuse.
You're
people.
Going to comment or tweet LJ if you're able to make it for that day. He's there. What day is it going to be?
It's going to be 3 days, September 24th.
But what day
are
you going to have this meetup?
The last day, the
26th.
Saturday.
If you're able to be at Salt Lake City. For this Comic Con in the 26th, let us know in the comments if you're gonna be there, and if enough people are there, we're gonna figure something out. But it's no worth like discussing.
I mean, I'm not really sure why people would even be there unless they're
going
to the convention.
Yeah,
so
I don't know why people would be there either.
I mean, I'm not saying that they.
I doubt anyone's gonna drive
to
Salt Lake City just to see you.
Yeah, we're Z-list celebrities,
that's
man.
Why I'm
we're
saying
not gonna
if
get
you're
anywhere
in the Salt Lake area. I'm not saying.
But why
hey,
would they be there if they weren't
maybe
going
they
to the
live
convention?
There.
He's already made contact with one dude that won a Makuta Fest prize, and he's gonna hand deliver it to him in person.
With a Subway sandwich.
What is with the sandwiches? Nothing. No, there's nothing at all. Nothing about it. Don't Google it, kids. So.
Oh god, it's so really disgusting.
That'll be in a stupid episode.
Yeah,
okay,
but,
So yeah, just if you're gonna do it, you know, mention it in call. There is
don't
no way to stop
it.
Don't
mention it in comments.
So. How about we don't mention it until there's actually a plan?
No, there is a plan.
No, we need to know if people are interested.
No, there isn't. You don't even know when you're gonna meet them or where you're gonna meet them.
We need to know if people are interested before we do any plans.
You keep on hampering my decision.
Because your decision is freaking stupid.
At Salt Lake Comic Con. Why would you do anything at Salt Lake Comic Con? Okay.
All right, guys.
Evans and Sebastian.
Time
Stan.
To end. So thank you all for watching, and be sure to check us out on Vessel at vessel.com/the TTV channel for early access of all of our content. Buy a shirt at store.ttvpodcast.com and get a free trial for Audible and get free audiobooks at audibletrial.com/TTV. And that's pretty much all for today. So I am Messinac.
Yay.
I'm Bartaran.
I'm LJ.
I'm Kahi.
I'm Viper.
I'm Takuma Nova.
I'll see y'all next week for the next exciting episode of the TTV Podcast.
Goodbye.
Farewell.
See ya.
Oh, hey, quick update. Markiplier was on Kimmel last night, so... Hey, cool. Just so we don't
nobody
date ourselves.
Nobody cares.
What do you do?
I'm tying it back, guys. I'm tying it back. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. Oh, right, stick around for after show.
What oh, yeah, I forgot. Yeah, after show.
Bye. Can you bashing open?
Yeah, no.
All right.